Welcome to this whole new series where I dig deep into how much effort goes into launching a new application or updates to tools that we already know and love. In this first episode, I sit down with Max and Oscar from OSMAKO, the makers of LiveApp Pro. Over the past 6 weeks, we've met via Zoom for weekly updates as they plan, build, and launch their new iOS application, LiveApp Play, and add some features to their existing app, LiveApp Pro. So settle in for lots of chat about software decisions and what it's like to build an app as they go from idea to launched.
And we have two main things we want to tackle. The first thing is the most used feature of the app is video playback. We really like the LiveApp Pro set of features, but we would like to have a second version of it that's just the core of video queue and also probably less expensive, so it's more affordable for users. The second one is that we know from a lot of users and also ourselves that there's a big use case for using like old iPhones as a playback device. This could be like a really cool setup for someone who has one lying around, or a remote version for playback or something like that.
Whenever you're building this new set of features, what do you think will be the simple part, and what will be the extremely not so simple, difficult part?
In general, it's always the other way around than you think first. I always think the easy part is easy and the hard part is hard, and then it's always the other way around. The next step, maybe that's why it's easy, is to do the UI redesign, like all the components to resize them. A big uncertainty for us right now is how does the new feature work, like the importing.
The challenge for me is going to be to figure out the best architecture for having multiple targets, multiple devices, multiple sets of features, and ideally having a single code base. So that makes it a lot easier to maintain and implement the same features across both apps.
It's a pretty clear task to redesign the iPhone version, because it has to become a lot smaller and a lot more usable. I think next time we can talk a lot more about the next step we took in the UX UI design state. I hope we will be done by now. What I really hope we have by then is the prototype or a tech prototype for our import feature.
Okay, cool. Well, great. I'm going to stop this recording now.
So it's been a week since we last chatted. What has changed? What's worked? What's not worked? Tell me all about it.
Basically, we spend a lot of time thinking about the UI changes we have to do in order to get the iPad version of the app to the iPhones. When we redesigned the video queue, we also thought of how does it look on the smallest version if you do a split screen. And in the end, we landed on this one. We can see that we worked a lot on how big should this preview windows be. And in the end, we decided it's the main focus. We want to check what's happening, and there is still enough space beneath it to see all of the sections. There's a lot of trial and error moving stuff around to fit the right size of the columns and the right size of the thumbnail, so you can still see it, but it's enough space. What doesn't work yet is that we have two more buttons in the taskbar. That's output and autoplay. We dropped them yet, but we would like to get them back. But then there's like the second part we wanted to do this week. We also did manage to do. It's building the first prototype for the upload feature, so the browser upload.
This is the realization of the design that Oscar just showed us, and it's fully interactable. So you can scroll, you can collapse, you can click on things. We're missing the two toolbar buttons and some smaller things about the sheet, stuff like that. We wanted to start with the first level. In the oncoming weeks, we will go deeper, check how the layout adapts and make sure it works. For example, whether you have a notch or a home button or no home button. And so we're really happy with how this scales. We have this bootstrap page that doesn't look pretty and doesn't use our design language yet. The idea is to make a quick prototype and validate the feature idea, keep iterating quickly on it. I can go ahead and I can upload a file here. And as you can see, it appears as a new section. What we have done here, we are utilizing an existing feature, which is a skip feature. So you can skip videos in a section, and it means they don't come up in the playback. And the cool part is that this is using a local web server, so I can even open the page on other devices in the local network. I can upload files from there. So for example, I just took a quick video here of me on the iPhone and just imported it here.
Cool. All right. Until next week.
Yeah.
Good luck.
See you then. Thank you.
Right. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Changes from last time. Now the project actually builds to all targets. I have my iPhone connected and the iPad is simulated, kind of experimenting with different target audiences. So last time we demoed the quick prototype bootstrap design of the inbox server. So now we have settings UI for that, where you can turn on the server. First, you get the QR code and the IP address of the device. And then as soon as it's registered, you get also the bonjour local device name URL. You can also scan the QR code from your device and you get the web page, both on the desktop and on the mobile. You can upload files. We are now, let's say, feature complete. We have like 7 open ticket items, like small bug and UI fixes, some backend stuff, but then we kick off the beta testing cycle. We hoped to be able to do that today, but we didn't. All right, so if we are ready, then I would add you to the LiveApp Play, as we have now decided to call it.
Okay, this time I've got the options and I'll just do the video version.
And there you have also different controls like loop and the switcher action. And on the video side of things, you also have like basic controls over in and out points. We really hope it feels that way, that it's like purposely built for iPhone and not just shrunken down. For example, select 4 videos in the Files app and you import them, then it's like one section.
As far as I see, I'm sure you saw lots of things, but as far as I see, there's no real issues. It could just be pushed out tomorrow.
And we prefaced it by saying this is a first beta version and we still have anyway some UI fixes and some bug fixes left to do. So we just add a few items to the list. In addition to launching the test flight beta for you, John, we also did it for a small group of other external testers, and they already found 2 more small bugs from the version that you're having right now to, let's say, closer to the final version. We already have 2 more items on our list.
But small things that you know, small bugs or anything major that you're worried about?
For example, we don't have a physical iPod Touch. We try to simulate all of the devices there are. It worked fine in the simulator, but somebody had a physical iPod Touch and for some reason, I know the reason, and it would load the iPad interface, so the huge interface on the small iPod Touch. So instead of the purposely build iPhone interface, it would load the iPad interface.
Development-wise, it's really close to being done. That's really far. And then what we still have to do, and this is kind of something that gets neglected or like overseen, is how much work there is like on the final stretch of just publishing it. For example, like rewriting the App Store description, or for example, for the new app, we have to completely write a new description, and also doing all the screenshots, which are not just screenshots, but more of a like display of what the app is capable of.
Today, ideally by 5 p.m., you can press the go live button.
Exactly. So we will press the go live button for the apps. I hope I can also press the go live button for the YouTube video. Definitely press the live button on like a promo photo and text on, I don't know, our different social media channels.
What can we look at today as the last thing to chat about?
I didn't change much for the pro version, but I wanted to implement the import via local network feature. And so we have that here. I tried to make it a lot consistent overall. So it seems like one go of screenshots. So we have these like drop shadow effects, floating windows without any devices. Last week I had the screenshot of an iPhone Safari browser. Mm-hmm. It looks a bit like it's an iPhone or iPad screenshot, or is it in the app, or how does it differentiate? Mm-hmm. So what I did is this is basically isn't even a screenshot. It's a rebuilt version of Edge. I wanted to use Edge because I wanted to make clear that there's no Apple device necessary for it to work. I wanted to make sure that there's a big differentiation between the Pro and the Play version, going with a blue background, matching like the blue color of the blue icon. And also our playback is always blue. I decided to do that and also do white text on blue. If I don't manage to do everything today, it's also not a big deal. So it can be come over the next few days, but I try to make as much possible as I can today.
Our final call in this series. That was fun.
It's a bit sad.
Good luck.
Thank you.
See ya.
Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
LiveApp Play is now available on the App Store, and the link is below this video. And you can also check out the new features on LiveApp Pro. Be sure to update if you already have it, or check it out with the link below as well. Please do give it a look. Let us know in the comments below what you think of the app and what you thought of this kickoff video as well. If you're a developer working on your next big app or feature, please do reach out. I'd love to get you on for an episode of Idea to Launched as well. And finally, a big thanks to Max and Oscar for letting me look behind the scenes on this. We spent about 6 hours chatting with each other over the last few weeks, and somehow my wife has managed to edit that into this 10-minute video. It's been quite the challenge, but a really nice process. So that's it. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.